Good morning, students. So today again I come with a new topic which is photochemical equilibrium or photostationary state. What is photostationary state? That will be discussed later. First, I would like to give a brief introduction or brief background regarding the chemical equilibrium or normal chemical equilibrium. What is a chemical equilibrium? In a chemical equilibrium, it is generally observed that certain reactant or reactants interact among each other and forms the product, and when the concentration of the product reaches a particular value, then the backward reaction also start, and after that both the reaction, that means the forward reaction and the backward reaction, proceeds with the same velocity. And from outside there is no observable change is found, but the reaction is proceed, the reaction is not in the static condition, and at that condition the equilibrium constant, or that is the K equilibrium, depends both on the reactant concentration and the product concentration. It is not independent on the concentration of the either reactant or products. So let's come to the point of interest for today, that is the photostationary state. The photostationary state is a steady state which arises if the forward or backward or both reactions in a reversible reaction sequence is affected by radiation. So that means it tells that in a photostationary state is basically a chemical equilibrium reaction where both reactants or products can be affected basically in presence of particular wavelength of light. Okay, so let us consider a reaction that is A in equilibrium B, that means reactant A produce B and again B is produces A again. So the normal equilibrium constant, that is the chemical equilibrium constant, you can say, is the activity of B at equilibrium divided by activity of A at equilibrium. And here keep in mind that I have not used the concentration terms because this is not happened in the solution phase, and better for clarity or better for convenience use the activity terms. Okay, in solution we simplified this thing, that taking that activity equal to concentration into activity coefficient, and for dilute solution activity coefficient value is tends to 1. That's why we use in very frequent case concentration terms, but in the true sense use the activity terms. Okay, so if the reaction, that is the forward reaction A to B or B to A, are not affected by radiation, then the equilibrium constant K will not change, and there will be no change in equilibrium position in presence of the radiation. That means suppose you are irradiated with this reaction vessel with some certain frequency or wavelength of light, and observe that there is no change is happening. That means both the reactants or products or any of them is not affected by this radiation, and there is no change in the equilibrium position of this reaction. Okay, but if one or both are affected by light, that means if reactants or products or both at the same times absorb the radiation, then there will be a change. Then K will change and a new equilibrium position with different concentration value of A and B arises. Let the equilibrium activities of A and B are constant, activity of B at equilibrium and activity of A at equilibrium at a particular temperature T naught. If the radiation affects A to B and also B to A, means both the forward and the backward reaction scheme, then we may define a quantity, that is K prime, and K prime equal to B, activity of B divided by activity of A. That means first you will allow the reactants to reach the equilibrium, that means this is already reaches the equilibrium, and then you irradiate the sample or the reaction vessel with this particular wavelength of light, and then observe that the concentration of the, or sorry, better I can use the term activity, the activities of both A and A, B are changing, okay, at a particular temperature T naughts, and that new condition equilibrium constant, that is K prime equal to activity of B by activity of A. Where activity of B and activity of A are the activities of B and A respectively in the steady state or stationary state, or you can say photostationary state, because it is happening in presence of light. The steady state is generally independent of temperature and depends on the wavelength of the radiation, because if you at that condition change the temperature, that will not affect anymore, because this reaction is susceptible to light only. There is no parameter appearing in this equation, as temperature. So if you change the temperature from T naught to T prime, T naught prime, there will be no observable change. Okay. The steady state or stationary state activity of B may be independent of the activity of A, and hence the definition of the quantities like K prime are not necessary. That means once this photostationary state have arrived, then the activity of B and activity of A, they are not dependent on each other, because initially it starts that activity of B and activity of A are dependent on each other, because if you change the activity of A, then definitely as they are, this is the ratio of this is the ratio that the equilibrium constant is taking the taken as a ratio of the activity of B by activity of A. And if you change the activity of A in the meantime, once it reaches equilibrium, normal equilibrium, then definitely the activity to make this thing that is K equilibrium constant at a particular temperature, the activity of B also changes. Okay. Now, if you change the temperature once it reaches the photostationary state or photochemical equilibrium state, then there is no relation between the activity of B and activity of A. Okay, they are at that time independent of each other. So independent of each other. Okay, so independent activity of A, and hence the definition of the quantities like K prime are not necessary, because at that time once it reaches the equilibrium state, there is no value of activity of B or activity of A is ratio of K prime, because K prime is independent. So one of the well-known example that exhibiting the photostationary state is the photochemical equilibrium. It is the dimerization of anthracene. When anthracene dimerizes in presence of light, then this photostationary state arrived easily. Okay, the following mechanism have been proposed for the photochemical dimerization of anthracene A. So let me allow to change the page. So here the A is used for anthracene molecules. So first A is taken the particular wavelength light h nu and form the excited state anthracene, that is A star, and the rate of the reaction is Ia, because we know that for this particular step the quantum yield equal to 1. As quantum yield equal to 1, and we know that quantum yield equal to the ratio of the rate of the reaction divided by the intensity of the radiation. That means rate of the reaction equal to intensity. That's why rate of this reaction is the Ia, that is the intensity of the light. And the second step, the excited state anthracene can react with the ground state anthracene and form the dimer. And this is the rate constant for this particular step is K2, and rate equal to K2 into C A star, concentration of A star into concentration of A, that is C A star into C A, where C means concentration of this particular species. Here keep in mind that the rate of this reaction depends only on the concentration of the reactants. Okay, so that's why the rate for this particular step equal to K2 into concentration of A star, concentration of A. And at the same time the dimer can dissociate also, and this is the dimer, that is A2. That it is dissociated to two ground state molecules. Okay, and the rate of this reaction, rate constant for this particular step is K3, and rate of the reaction you can write here like K3 into concentration of A2, and this is equation number 3. And if there this is another possibility, that before it forming a dimer, that means before the excited anthracene interact with the ground state anthracene molecule and form the dimer, it can lose a photon and come back to the ground state easily. That means A star can lose its energy as a photon and come back to the ground state, and the rate constant for this reaction is K4, and rate of the reaction is K4 into concentration of A star. Okay, now if you'd like to find the rate of the formation of the dimer, that means ddt of CA2, that is the rate of the formation of the dimer. And dimer is formed in this step, that is K2 into C A star into C A, and dimer is vanishing in this step. So minus, because of this it is decreases the concentration, so it's considered as minus. So minus K3 into C A2. Now here we have to use the very common and generalized concept of steady state approximation, because we assume that during the entire reaction scheme or reaction span, the concentration of the active or you could say excited anthracene, that is A star, maintain a steady value of its concentration, then the rate of change of the concentration of the excited state anthracene equal to 0 because it maintains a steady value or constant value. So a constant value, if you differentiate this constant value with respect to time, that gives you a zero value. So dt of ca star equal to 0. And in which step ca star, concentration a star is formed, that is first step a star is formed, so rate equal to plus ia because it is forming, and the second step it is depleting or decreasing, so it comes with a negative sign, that is ia minus k2 into ca star into ca. And in the third step there is no contribution, and the fourth step again it decreases the concentration of a star, so with a minus sign k4 into ca star, and this is equal to 0. So if we'd like to find the concentration of a star from this reaction, so c a star equal to, so you just put this ia in one side of this equation and all these terms containing a star c a star in the opposite side, and taking the c a star as common, so it comes out to be c a star equal to ia divided by k2 into ca plus k4. Now putting the value of C star, whatever you find from this equation, that is equation number 6, to this equation, that is equation number 5, you get this ddt of Ca2 equal to K2 into impedance of C star. I would like to put Ia by K2 into Ca plus K4, that is Ia by K2 Ca plus K4 into Ca minus K3 into K3 into Ca2, that is equation number 7. Now, you know that once the photostationary state have arrived, then photostationary state means the which step the particular species of interest is formed and it vanishes. That means this is the forward reaction, a star plus a form a2, because we would like to form the observe the dimerization of anthracene. So this is the dimer and the dimer is depleted, so these two steps are photostationary state. So in the photostationary state, reaction 2 and 3 represents an equilibrium reaction, and at that condition what happened, the rate of the reaction becomes equal, because that's why they appear as equilibrium, because we know that once any reaction comes under equilibrium, then the forward and backward both the rate of this reaction are same. So if the rate of this reaction are same, then we can write that dCa2 by dt equal to 0. Okay, then what happened from this equation, if you put that condition of 0 because it appears as photostationary state, then concentration of Ca2, now in this equation you put that's equal to 0, and K3A2 put in a right side of the equation and all the terms in the left side of the equation, and from this you can find easily the concentration of A2, that is Ca2 equal to K2 into Ia into Ca, that is these terms, divided by K3, because K3 was along with this C2, so K3 multiplied by within bracket K2 Ca plus K4. And if now I'd like to divide these total terms by both the numerator and denominator by K2 into Ca, then what happened? Only Ia is remaining, and here in this equation, this becomes 1 and K4 by K2 into Ca multiplied by K3. Now, if we assume that the concentration of A, that means we have used a huge concentration of the anthracene in the reaction vessel, then what happened? These terms, that is K2 into Ca, is very large, because the concentration of Ca is very large, then the ratio K4 by K2 into Ca becomes a negligible quantity in comparison to 1, so we can neglect easily this quantity in comparison to 1. So the terms becomes at the time when Ca is very large, so concentration of A2, that is dimerization concentration, equal to Ia by K3. So that is the point of interest that we have just mentioned few minutes before, that the when a photostationary equilibrium is established, then the concentration of the product becomes independent on the concentration of the reactant, and this is the main difference between a normal equilibrium reaction and a photochemical equilibrium reaction, because in normal equilibrium reaction every step or every fragment of the reaction or every time fraction of the reaction, the concentration of the both reactant and products are interrelated through their equilibrium constant. But in the photostationary state, once the photostationary state has arrived or reached, then the concentration of the product becomes independent on the concentration of the reactant, and that is the proof, because concentration of the product, that is the dimer, becomes independent on the concentration of the reactant, only depends on the photo light wavelength, the intensity of the light Ia and the K3, and K3 is basically the rate constant for the decomposition rate constant of this dimer. So that is when system reaches photostationary state, then the concentration of the dimer is independent on the concentration of the monomer. Okay, that is already established here. So this is unlike the thermal equilibrium, where we know that if we assume that this is the normal thermal equilibrium, two anthracene molecule reacts to form the dimer, and in the forward reaction and the backward reaction, the dimer is again depleted to form the monomer. So at that condition, the equilibrium constant becomes K equal to concentration of the product, that is A2 divided by concentration of monomer square, because two molecules is here. Okay. So, and Ca2 mass depends on Ca for the normal photochemical reaction, since K is a constant, because we know that the equilibrium constant is a constant at a particular temperature, and here we have not changed the temperature. That means every condition, concentration of A2 and A concentration of A are interrelated through the equilibrium constant. So however, the system reverts to the thermal equilibrium when the radiation is cut off. Now in this particular reaction, suppose once they arrived at the photostationary state or photochemical equilibrium state, and then you suddenly switch off the radiation, then this reaction is quenched to the normal thermal equilibrium in these steps, and then at that condition, the concentration of the A2, that is the concentration of the dimer, depends on the concentration of the monomer. But again, when you switch on the irradiation or your light source, then the system becomes independent. That means the concentration of the product, that is the dimer, becomes independent on the concentration of the reactant. So this is the beauty of the photostationary state, you have to always keep in mind the difference, the basic difference between the normal equilibrium state and the photostationary equilibrium state. Okay, so however, when the system reverts to the thermal equilibrium when the radiation is cut off. So this is the total things regarding the photostationary state. Okay, thank you.